I'm Amy Gray, Education Director at the Anniston Museums and Gardens.
And I'm Sarah Burke, Assistant Director.
And we're here at the Longleaf Botanical Gardens to celebrate National Watermelon Day. Now, did you know that watermelons have actually been around for about 5,000 years? Watermelons are native to Africa, and then about the 10th century made their way to China. China is now the number one producer of watermelons in the world.
I did not know that.
Yes.
Man.
And now what we have in front of us here is a seedless watermelon. Mm. A lot of people believe that these are genetically modified, but they actually are not. They're a hybrid. And so what they did, well, they actually crossbred two different watermelons. One only had 22 chromosomes, the other one had 44 chromosomes. And so together what they do is they create basically a sterile version of the watermelon, and they have these immature white seeds which you can eat.
Yeah.
Now, you've probably heard the thing of maybe when you were growing up and your mom said, don't eat that watermelon seed because what's going to happen?
You will grow a watermelon in your belly.
That's right.
Yes.
But that is not true. Watermelon seeds, while are a little hard,
yeah,
right?
I definitely ate a couple growing up.
Exactly. Yeah. But they are actually really high in different vitamins and minerals. So while the texture may not be the greatest, it's not going to hurt you. Yeah, it can actually benefit you.
Okay.
Good
to know.
So we have a fun third Thursday this month up at the Longleaf Botanical Garden. So Sarah, why don't you tell us about that?
Yes, absolutely. So if you like watermelon as much as I do, then you need to come to our third Thursday. It's the Watermelon Wingding.
Okay.
Amy Gray doesn't like watermelon, so she's not invited. But, sorry.
That's okay. One of those strange people.
But watermelons, we're going to have an assortment, so we'll have several varieties. You know, there's like yellow watermelon, there's the seedless watermelons. We usually end up with about four or five varieties, and we slice them up. We have our education committee with us, who is a great source of volunteers that help us create all these wonderful programs here at Longleaf Botanical Gardens.
And are super knowledgeable.
Oh my gosh, yes. They've helped any plant that I've ever touched. But they come together, and we chop up all this watermelon, and we do a tasting. And it's so much fun for the whole family, because we get people of all ages. We get the kids in here, and you can't eat watermelon, you know, cleanly. It's always a mess.
Exactly.
Because, I mean, it's water, right?
So 90% water.
See, exactly. Statistics. But we come out, we have all these chopped up pieces of watermelon. You taste them, you vote on what your favorite is, and then Hayes Jackson, our Longleaf Botanical Gardens director, he'll tell you a little bit more about watermelon, maybe how the variations are made, a little bit about the taste, and even all the fun names. So every year I've come to it, and I taste watermelon I've never had before, and they go throughout the county to find the different variations of it. So it's a lot of fun. It's messy. It's third Thursday of August, Watermelon Wingding. It's at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. So we know school will be back in session. Mm-hmm. So you guys can go home, cool off after a long school day, bring the kids out to the Longleaf Botanical Gardens and enjoy some watermelon with us. We'll even have plant sales throughout the day. So from 10 until 5, mm-hmm. if you have a green thumb, if you want a green thumb, if you are nurturing your green thumb, come on out to the greenhouses. When you're on your way up Museum Drive, it's the last left-hand turn just before you go up the hill. We have so many different types of plants up there for sale too.
So with Third Thursday, is there a cost involved with that?
Such a good question. So Third Thursday is $5 a person unless you're an Anniston Museums and Gardens member. If you're a member, it's free for you. So
what a great
come
perk.
On out and, exactly. Come on out and see us. Of course, if you have a little that's age 0 to 3, those guys are free too.
So. Right. Well, thank you, Sarah. So again, come and join us at the Anniston Museums and Gardens. We hope you check out not only the Longleaf Botanical Garden, as you can see behind us, but also the Anniston Museum of Natural History and the Berman Museum. And you can explore your world from anything from plants and animals to watermelon.
Watermelon.
So we hope to see you on Third Thursday.
Thanks, guys.